This video is made possible by CuriosityStream. When you sign up for an annual subscription, you'll also get access to Nebula, my own streaming site, co-founded with dozens of other educational creators. The geography of South America is pretty strange. It's home to 14 countries, including the very famous South American countries of the Netherlands and France. But wait, hang on, those countries are in Europe. Alas, that might largely be true, but do tell me, which country does France share her longest border with? You'd probably want to say something like Germany or Belgium or perhaps even Spain, but if you measure them all up, the answer that you're going to end up getting is delightfully Brazil. You see, there's a chunk of France in South America that's marked on maps as French Guiana, but it's not an independent country. It's literally 100% fully a part of France and the European Union, the same way that Alaska is part of the United States. So because of this goofy little geographic quirk, the largest national park in the European Union is actually not located anywhere in Europe, but in South America, inside of French Guiana, the Guyana Amazonian Park. Right next door to France here is Suriname, and despite Suriname and Brazil sharing a fairly long border between them, there isn't a single road that connects them together, meaning that right now, the only way for you to drive from Brazil into Suriname or vice versa is to either drive through Guyana first or France. And speaking of Brazil, it's important for me to show you exactly how huge a country Brazil actually is. This is the northernmost point of Brazil, and this down here is the southernmost point of Brazil. How many other countries do you think the northernmost point is closer to than it is to the southernmost point? Obviously, places like Venezuela, Guyana, and the now not so unexpected France, but if you measure all of the distances out in straight great circle lines, you'll find that the northernmost point is closer to Colombia, Argentina, Ecuador, Mexico, and even the United States than it is to Brazil's southernmost point. But it can't be closer to Canada too. Can it? Well, if you measure it out again, you'll actually see that, yep, most unexpectedly, Brazil's northernmost point is even closer to Canada, too, than it is to Brazil's southernmost point. Brazil's northernmost point is, in fact, closer to every single other country in the Americas than it is to Brazil's southernmost point, a fact that defies most appeals to common sense. But even more shocking than that is this. What geographic location do you believe is closer to Brazil, Miami or Africa? Starting again at the same northernmost point of Brazil, the straight shot distance over to Miami is 2,898 kilometers as the crow flies, but Brazil's easternmost point over here is only 2,883 kilometers away from Sierra Leone across the mid-Atlantic, which means that Brazil is located a very narrow 15 kilometers closer to Africa than it is to Miami, meaning that you can factually say that Miami is further away from Brazil than Africa. The biggest reason for why this may come as a surprise to you is because most of us in the Northern Hemisphere have a weird misunderstanding of where exactly South America is located geographically. We all know that South America is, of course, south of North America, but it's easy to forget or simply not know that South America isn't directly south of North America. If you're in the United States and look south and you draw a straight line down from your gaze, it's unlikely that that line will ever actually hit South America. This is because if you start in Jacksonville, Florida, and draw a line straight down across the globe, you'll discover that the entire South American continent lies just to the east of this line. South America is so far east that the entire continent is significantly east of Detroit, and therefore most of the United States. South America is much further east than most of us believe it to be in our heads, and because of that, there's some other interesting geographic implications. Despite not being strictly located in South America, the Panama Canal is close enough to warrant some mention here. The canal enables ships to travel between the western Pacific Ocean and the eastern Atlantic Ocean quickly without having to sail all the way around South America. But if you zoom in closer to the canal itself, you discover that ships travel through it in a rather unexpected direction. If you're starting in the eastern Atlantic Ocean and you're going across the canal to the western Pacific Ocean, you actually begin in the north and generally travel southeast to reach the Pacific. To further complicate your confusion, the Atlantic side of the canal is actually further to the west than the Pacific side is, which means that to travel from the Atlantic to the Pacific, you actually end up traveling east. South America is so far southeast that it's actually on the exact opposite side of the world from Asia. If you began anywhere in South America and dug a hole straight down to the other side, here is a map showing you where you'd end up popping out at. If you began in Argentina or Chile, you'd end up somewhere in Siberia, Mongolia, or China. Paraguay would get you into Taiwan, Peru would cause you to wind up in Vietnam, Cambodia, or Malaysia, Brazil would get you into the Philippines or Indonesia, while Colombia, Venezuela, Guyana, Suriname, and French Guyana would all end up putting you across the various islands of Indonesia. So, yeah, South America's geography is probably a little weirder than you might have thought it was. Now, if you've made it this far into watching, then you probably love real-life lore, and I'm sure that you've probably already heard all about CuriosityStream, the documentary streaming service that has thousands of videos on geography, history, engineering, and tons of other things. But thanks to CuriosityStream, when you sign up for them, you'll also get access to Nebula, a streaming service made by educational creators like me, where we can publish our original, thoughtful content without fear of getting demonetized or buried by YouTube's dreaded algorithm. By signing up for CuriosityStream and Nebula, you are directly empowering me and dozens of other educational creators you probably know to make cool, exclusive content that we might not ever get the chance to make otherwise. Content like all of my own real-life lore videos that go up at least 24 hours early before they ever do on YouTube, and all without any ads or sponsorships. And exclusive content like Money, a game show hosted by Tom Scott, and featuring a bunch of my creator friends in a series of psychological experiments that test their willingness to work together. Best of all, though, CuriosityStream is offering Nebula subscribers 26% off just for you. In other words, that's two fantastic streaming services for less than $15 a year. So go ahead and sign up using the link in the description or by going to curiositystream.com/reallifelore. Watch cool content and support creators by watching stuff we've made just for you. Everyone wins, and as always, thank you for watching.